Today we're going to talk about these Bob Stoops to Ohio State rumors for a job that's not even open, as well as some news and notes you need to know, and all that's coming up after the bumper.
What do you mean you don't subscribe to my son's YouTube channel?
Mama, no!
Just snap the damn ball, RJ.
What's up, kid folk? It's RJ Young. I am not on a step mill. Consider hitting the like and subscribe button because I upload a video every single day. It's always OU related, college football related, sports related. We have a good time and it's free. And if you watch the videos, you know now that we're playing Fortnite on Monday night. That'd be August 6th at 6 p.m. Central Time because that's when videos drop. You see, semblance and whatnot. I'm going to be on for an hour. Gamer tag is I am leveled up. Xbox Live. Sorry. Haven't got around to getting a PS4 yet. And if you watch the videos, you know. If you don't watch the videos on the same day, you don't know. Sorry. So first, some news and notes you need to know, some of which are insider over on the VIP board at OUinsider.com. And while I'm going to tell you a few things, there's a lot of other stuff that Brandon Drum has reported that I'm telling you will blow your mind about what's going on inside the team and around recruiting. But let's start with this. The Bookie Effect is real. In fact, I made a video about this, quoting Rodney Anderson and Kenneth Murray Jr. about just what Bookie has done since he's arrived at Oklahoma. And a source quote about how Bookie has looked during practice and during summer work goes like this. Bookie is already in the film room trying to learn what he needs to do to get better. He helped run and put together 7-on-7s. And the guy isn't afraid to talk like and act like a leader, which is exactly what you need in this secondary because, again, we're very talented, but we're very young. In particular, we're going to have to figure out who's going to play free and strong safety, along with a really great and deep battle for who's going to start at corner. The next thing you need to know is 5-star 2019 quarterback Spencer Rattler has decided he will not enroll early, saying, quote, "I want to still be able to enjoy my senior year and not get bogged down with classwork. Need to be able to focus on my football season too." So Rattler will be headed to Norman in June 2019, which gives Austin Kendall an edge whether or not he wins the starting job or not in this quarterback competition, because we know how much of an emphasis is placed on freshmen enrolling early and how much playing time they usually see based on that alone. See Bookie. I expect to see a lot of Ronnie Perkins too, along with other early enrollees for this 2018 class. And I don't think Spencer's gonna show up and win the starting job over a summer. I think if Austin Kendall decides to stay, and there's no guarantee that he will, he's going to be the front runner for a job that I don't think Kyler Murray's going to be around in 2019 to compete for or keep, because I do believe the Oakland Athletics want their baseball player playing baseball in 2019, despite what Lincoln Riley has said about Kyler Murray having the option if he wants to play quarterback again. Next thing you need to know is Derek Green is all in on Oklahoma, and in particular, Coach Calvin Thibodeau, defensive ends coach. He spent a lot more time with Coach Thibodeau at the Champ U barbecue because his sheepdog, Pops Ruffin McNeil, was a little under the weather, but he came away feeling great about Calvin Thibodeau, saying, "Coach Tibbs is a big overgrown little kid. He's an overgrown little kid and he's gonna sit there and play and he's gonna mess around, but he's going to teach us and work on us to make sure that we are good and that we understand the schemes and everything. But he's just a little kid, like he wants to be out there, like he wants to play, and that's just how everybody is. I like that." I have a story coming next week about Derek Green and just what his recruitment has looked like. But that was the feeling I got from everybody I talked to who attended the Champ U barbecue last Sunday. It's a family atmosphere. They want to be there. They feel like Lincoln Riley and the staff all the way down have their best interest at heart. And that is what most people come away feeling from Oklahoma, is the sense of family and community that is infectious and convinced offensive tackle Stacy Wilkins to commit to Oklahoma on Friday. Wilkins became the first offensive tackle commit for this 2019 class, joining offensive linemen EJ Ndoma Ogar and Marcus Alexander in a 2019 class that is shaping up to be an all-timer. After announcing his decision at a ceremony in his native Camden, Arkansas, he told OU Insider he felt like he was walking around his own crib, and his parents wanted him to go to OU, and I've always said, if you don't win the parents, you don't win the kid. There aren't too many Alex Collinses out there who just want to go against their parents' wishes and go to Arkansas. And even when that happened, you'll remember his mother absconded with his national letter of intent because she wanted to go to Miami. It is that powerful. Do not discount parents, no matter what you think in recruiting. And you'd be wise to think that all parents are watching universities and coaches in particular to figure out what is best for their child. And Stacy Wilkins was trying to do what's best for him and his family, which means picking OU over Arkansas, saying, "I have to do what's best for me and my family. That's it. I feel like Coach Bill Beatonbow knows his stuff, and he's so cool with me. Coach Riley is young and chill, too. I just love the vibe I get at OU, and that's where I feel most comfortable. So with Wilkins' commitment, Oklahoma vaulted from number 6 to number 4 in the 24/7 composite team rankings with just 17 commits. And that's a big deal because at number 2, Alabama has 20 total commits. And at number 3, Texas A&M has 24 total commits. Both of those teams each only have one 5-star committed to the class. Oklahoma has 2. And while it seems like Georgia's gonna run away with the recruiting title, if things stand what they are with a mind-boggling 5 5-star recruits in their number 1 2019 class, feels like Oklahoma could at least finish number 3, if not number 2, depending on what happens late in recruiting, in particular with the one Dax Hill, who is my favorite uncommitted recruit right now because he is a pure sphinx and I'm digging it. Like, he deked everybody when the written official offers went out, and he tweeted official written offers from Michigan, Oklahoma State, and Alabama, allowing folks to run with the idea that Oklahoma is out of the running, and then comes out with the official written offer from Oklahoma. Now, we know Dax Hill did not attend the Champion Barbecue, which you can say doesn't help Oklahoma, but Tulsa World sports columnist Bill Haston is as plugged into the Dax Hill recruiting situation as anybody in America, and he has it from Dax's dad that the commitment date has been pushed to after Dax Hill takes an official visit to Michigan, which would mean an announcement would be around mid-September, but because the commitment date keeps being pushed and pushed back, I would take that with a grain of salt. If you follow Dax on Twitter, that's probably the best way to listen to what's going on, but he's not really giving out hints. In fact, he tweeted on August 3rd, "A wise man said nothing at all." To which I say, there are two sisters. One gives birth to the other, and she, in turn, gives birth to the first. Who are the two sisters? Dax knows the answer, because he is both the guardian and the city of thieves. And with that said, could another safety prospect be in play for Oklahoma? And not one you're really thinking about. I'm thinking about safety Josh Proctor, who is in Columbus, Ohio now as a Buckeye. But you gotta wonder, with this scandal going down at Ohio State where Urban Meyer has been placed on administrative leave, should the worst happen for Ohio State fans and they lose their head coach and these kids are allowed to leave, does that mean Josh Proctor starts looking back at Oklahoma? It could happen. And we know how Oklahoma wants and needs good safeties, especially in this league. But this will be a thing to watch as this seismic activity out of Ohio State reaches Baylor proportions. And you see a mass exodus of recruits from Ohio State. Now, we gotta talk about Bob Stoops to Ohio State and the rumor. Now, the math is such that Bob Stoops stepped down as the head coach at Oklahoma so that Lincoln Riley could assume the position. And at 57 years old, he's growing a beard, he's playing more golf, he's enjoying his special status as the retired legend of Oklahoma football. But since Dan Wolkin wrote his column for USA Today with source quotes from folks around college football who say that Bob Stoops would be in a class of his own should Ohio State decide to fire Urban Meyer and go looking for a new head coach. Now, we understand why this is true. Bob Stoops is one of the best college football coaches walking around today. And he's also a native of Youngstown, Ohio. And we all know how folks like to tie hometowns to the schools. But what people seem to forget is, number one, Bob Stoops retired because he wanted to, meaning he doesn't want to coach football anymore at this level. And number two, he just got a statue put up in Norman. You don't take another job after they give you a statue. That's just not the thing that you do. And Bob Stoops is not Kevin Durant. He calls himself an Oklahoman. He said that at the spring game in 2018. Hello? So if Ohio State is smart, they'll just go steal Tom Herman from Texas because he can't do any worse. Or they can whip to Minnesota where PJ Fleck is an up-and-coming head coach, and that's probably what they would need. But take Bob Stoops' name out your mouth because it just ain't happening. That's it for me. Deuces.